Hello, and welcome back to XRP Vault, where we bring you the most recent and intriguing XRP news. We're giving away 10,000 XRP to those who are watching. All you have to do is upvote, subscribe, comment XRP is king, and watch the video to the end to be eligible. The winners will be picked next month and publicized on the community page of the channel. What theory was advanced by John Deaton? How much does it matter? How will the trial be impacted by this theory? In our video from today, we will respond to these queries. Deaton asserts that he doesn't foresee a significant delay in Judge Torres' decision-making process regarding the motions for summary judgment. According to attorney John Deaton, the United States Securities and Exchange Commission's complaint against Ripple will be resolved shortly. In response to questions regarding whether the judge's ruling on dogbear motions gives any hints on the timing for her summary judgment decision, the founder of CryptoLaw today revealed this information in a tweet. The originator of CryptoLaw is a friend of the case and is able to speak for thousands of additional holders. Deaton expressed his skepticism over the likelihood of significant delays. The lawyer predicted that the judge would announce her ruling as soon as tomorrow or that it might take a few weeks. Based on what has been written today, according to the judge's ruling on the dogbear motion, both parties' motions to exclude expert testimony were somewhat granted and partially denied. The SEC used expert opinions to support its claims that holders of Pure tokens bought the token with a reasonable expectation of profits solely from Ripple's efforts. But as the report points out, XRP holders were the biggest winners as a result of Judge Torres' decision to throw out those expert opinions. Judge Torres' decision to throw out the expert testimony the SEC used to back up its accusations that XRP holders bought the token was the largest triumph for XRP owners. It is crucial to keep in mind that the defense attorney for the defendant in the case stated that it might take another 2 months to decide whether or not to classify XRP as a security. General counsel for Ripple Stuart Alberti stated there were three possibilities not so long ago. The court can opt to take the case to trial or find in favor of Ripple or the SEC. Deaton has stated that the conclusion he would most like to see the court reach is the clarification of the underlying claim that sales of XRP on secondary marketplaces represent unregistered securities offers. Even if Ripple loses in the lower court in the end, even if the judge rejects the sixth position on this matter, owners of XRP would still be able to celebrate a significant victory. Scott Chamberlain, an attorney and co-founder of Evernote Extra Pool, claims that neither the SEC nor the XRP community appear to have profited from the recent ruling. Following a recent ruling by Judge Analisa Torres, Chamberlain made a statement in which she allowed and denied portions of both sides' applications in an equal ratio. Expert testimony is necessary for Ripple and the SEC to support their claims and evidence regarding XRP. Neither the SEC nor the XRP community appear to have profited from this ruling, as the court partially accepted and partially denied both sides' motions. The absence of Patrick's duty was one of the decision's most significant implications. The SEC claimed that the primary expert witness engaged this company to investigate investors' expectations for XRP. Due in part to John Deaton's disclosure of the name of the attractive expert witness, SEC attorneys attempted to have Judge Torres bar Deaton and the XRP community attorney from taking part in the action. This was an unexpected consequence of the dogbear difficulties. Yet rather than forbid Deaton from testifying in court on behalf of XRP holders, the judge decided that Deaton should refrain from doing so. Similar opinions were voiced by an additional community attorney named Jeremy Hogan. He claimed that the SEC must demonstrate that investors had a reasonable expectation of profit from Ripple's efforts, and that duty was essential in proving this. While the judge ruled in favor of the sex on expert witness number 3, which Ripple had deemed irrelevant and unreasonably prejudicial, Hogan thinks that the topic of a fair expectation of profits can be addressed by expert opinion regarding Ripple's incentives and measures to impact the extra price. But he thinks it's weak sauce, which means it won't work in this situation. Johnny Deaton, an attorney, has said in its enforcement lawsuit against Ripple Labs, the U.S. Securities and Exchange Commission made a critical blunder in correctly identifying Ripple executives Chris Larson and Brad Garlinghouse. the creators of the crypto law attempted to explain why Judge Analisa Torres dismissed the gender objections to Ripple expert testimony on the non-security status of XRP by other authorities in a lengthy Twitter conversation yesterday. He claimed that the question of whether Ripple authorities acted foolishly by failing to realize that X was a security was answered by this testimony. In order for the court to find the executives guilty of aiding and abetting the sale of unregistered securities, the SEC will need to demonstrate this, as previously indicated by the attorney. The lawyer repeatedly asserted that the SEC and other government organizations had deemed XRP to be a non-security and that, by doing so, the agency had placed an unnecessary burden on itself. According to Deaton, the regulator may have taken this measure to coerce a settlement or to reduce the strength of the ripple effect in the nascent market. The lawyer defending 75,000 XRP holders in the case has predicted that the court's verdict in the legal conflict is soon. But in his opinion, this was a huge mistake, and the regulator will probably surely lose on this poll. Nobody foresaw that the launch of the XRP token in 2012 would lead to one of the most well-known legal battles in blockchain history, the SECQV's Ripple litigation. Before there was even a glimmer of the cryptocurrency business, Ripple was one of the largest digital assets. The women's case against Ripple dominated the cryptocurrency news for a while. But over time, enthusiasts have grown numb to the conflict. The outcome of the CC litigation will determine the future of XRP, Bitcoin, Ethereum, and the entire cryptocurrency market. When it was initially released in 2012, a distributed digital payment system like Bitcoin was called the Ripple blockchain. The main objective of Ripple's was to make it easier to move money internationally quickly and affordably. A complaint has been made against Ripple Labs, its CEO Brad Garlinghouse, and co-founder Chris Larson by the SEC. The XRP lawsuit in New York specifically refers to this instance. Judge Analisa Torres of the District Court is in charge of the proceedings. In light of the fact that dozens of people buy, sell, and exchange cryptocurrency tokens every day on secondary marketplaces, what exactly are the SEC and its intransigent chairman Gary Jeans EY prosecuting Ripple with? Why is XRP subject to such strict SEC regulation? The largest regulatory complaint in the cryptocurrency industry to date was brought by the SEC against Ripple Labs in 2020, saying that the business had raised over US$1 billion through the sale of additional coins. If you've been working with cryptocurrencies for longer than a week, you're probably already aware of how often exchanges like this host events. The SIX had a serious issue with Ripple Labs and its officials selling extra currencies since, in their eyes, these sales amounted to unregistered securities offers. Secretary XRP is a security, not a currency, according to the Securities and Exchange Commission, and is therefore governed by applicable securities laws. The Ripple CEO and co-founder, according to the SEC, were also less than honest during the sale. They contend that by making false and deceptive statements about the XRP coin and by neglecting to legally register the transaction, Garlinghouse and Larson violated federal securities laws. In conclusion, Gensler Leachy Company claimed that Ripple Labs intentionally withheld information from its investors despite knowing that snippets should be regarded as securities. However, XRP is not a security, according to supporters of Ripple, and hence it is not subject to federal securities laws oversight. According to Ripple Labs' definition, the XRP coin is not a security, whereas XRP is a currency and not a security. The accusations made against Ripple are false. According to Ripple, the core of the entire legal challenge is the SEC's improper designation of the extra point and the East or East South as an unregistered securities transaction. To add salt to the wound, Ripple claims that inconsistent approaches to cryptocurrency regulation impede a vibrant and forward-thinking industry.